hand imprints, mammoths and bisons, are the very first drawings and impressions made by our ancestors. They were made for a reason, to imitate and study nature, and to establish human connection. Through this expression, tribes could relate and communicate when there was no language spoken. The human species began its first art of expression in a cave. Later on, the human brain evolved into a much more complex practice. It grew towards depicting and producing the highest standards of excellence, while improving upon the work of previous generations. Later on in the 20th century, things started to move in a different direction. Replacing the inspirational with aesthetic relativism and beautiful into the ugly. Like to ask you something. As artists, if we cannot work to inspire and motivate the audience, what sort of legacy are we leaving behind? Art is terribly important as a survival mechanism for any culture. I say this because when we look into our past, nations who are highly respected and known for their magnificence in art, design and architecture are the ones who have established a system of growth. The art, design, and structures produced through classical ethics and principles are in fact invaluable. Those works are historic, they inspire, uplift the human emotions, and have not only deepened our thought process, but made us experience a standard of excellence in relation to the human connection. Such works were not built for machines or robots, but rather for the human condition. As Ornerdrum states, talent is something I respect. Our talent always remains classic. What happened to art? We live in a society where all efforts to refine and improve have been deemed decadent. As spectators, we see blank million-dollar canvases, vandalizing abstract and trash being promoted as some valuable statement in museums for the sake of art. Art, which is displayed in galleries for the sake of art, is not art. Thus, essence of the art of painting as a subject has been lost.
As we see, art, craft, and architecture broadcast a message. Good or bad art can either uplift or subdue the human spirit. The style of music, architecture, and art we leave behind also represents our legacy and the contribution to human society. What we build and create can directly impact our quality of life and our environment. That is why it matters, because aesthetic ugliness encourages ugly behavior. Even our institutional systems have become harmful to the cultural and individual development, because the group of people who are running our contemporary academic art and design institutes have demolished the true connection of our curriculum in a way that those guidelines which focused on imparting ethics of traditional techniques and principles through which a student refined and developed patience, skill and vision have been lost, hence causing a dysfunctional outcome. At any time in the past of classical painters, musicians and architects, Roger Scruton states that if one would have asked educated people the aim of poetry, art and music, they would have replied beauty. We as humans have the need to seek refuge in happiness and beauty. I believe beauty is not enough to save painting as a subject. Yes, it is a fundamental part and factor which is there, but to embrace the earnest, the sentimental and the craft, it is essential to understand the beauty of skill, refinement of talent and the passion required to produce such works, where we can again be human and understand the human condition. Our eternity is dependent on growth and talent, but unfortunately, talent and skill nowadays has diminished. Yet, I believe there is still hope.